Okay, it's connecting to server. Downloading to 1%. 2%. Yeah, it says the world size is only 3 megs, but this is an awful slow download. I mean, for 3 megabytes, because, you know, 3 megs is like nothing, but... Oh well. Still, it seems to be faster than you were able to download from me. 16% already. 17, 18, 19, 20. So, I will be with you in what appears to be about a minute. Maybe 2 minutes. I should go watch that YouTube, shouldn't I? Okay, now I've finally got to the loading screen, because it downloaded your entire... Oh, here we are. Okay, medical rooms. I think... this must be places I can spawn.
How you doing?
Hi, how you doing?
Hi, how you doing?
Hello.
Hey, are you hurting me? Holy crap.
Oh, I killed you. Oh, sorry.
I think friendly fire is gone.
Apparently.
Oh, I'm back. Okay, let me put out some tools. In my toolbar, character tools. Oh, hey, no guns. We only got mining stuff.
Where are the asteroids? I need them one.
Ah. Does this kill you?
Yeah, it's hit me.
Okay, you killed me with that. What about the blowtorch? This isn't... I guess the blowtorch can't do anything to people.
Wait a second, let me try...
Let's axle grind the ground, shall we? Turn it back into blocks. Look, see? I made blocks.
If I turn off my jetpack, you can fly around with me standing on you.
Oh yeah, I should turn off my jetpack. Whoa! Oh! I should turn on my inverters.
So, any idea how to turn on the...
I just found this, like, weird thing, but it works. So these are all light armor blocks. So. Oh god. Oh god, jetpack on. For some reason there was gravity and I was falling.
Your health is low.
Oh no, my health is low. Why is this landing here?
So, how do you get the asteroids to show up?
I assume it's random. They eventually showed up in my game, but that's after the game. Oh wow, I think I just destroyed the landing gear completely. Oh, wait, there's parts. Press T to pick up large steel tube. Oh, my inventory's full.
Inventory full.
I cannot pick up anything. Stuck down there. Anyway, I guess we want to put down some blocks and create some questions. I guess we gotta start putting blocks down this stuff, then we can detach them if we want to create our own separate flying thing.
It says you need a steel plate to build an armored block.
I think if you put in the survival mode restrictions, that's why we don't have an infinite amount of stuff. Like, I'm just building these, like, basic frame blocks, you know?
You want me to recreate the server without the restrictions?
No, it's okay. Let's figure it out for now.
Yeah, because it's telling me I need materials. Even if you can build the steel frame, you still need materials for the thrusters, right?
Okay, so now if I use my ankle grinder, I can unweld this block and... See, now I've got a floating platform, right? And now that I've got a floating platform, we can put stuff on. So we need a station. Oh, I need interior plate to build control station.
Yeah, you need materials. Is that something I should have turned off when I made the server?
Yeah, I guess so. If we can't even build control stations for our first ship, maybe you want to turn those requirements off.
How do I...
Okay, I'll quit and I'll use my loadscreen stuff to look at it. Well, you quit the server and then create it from the loadscreen as well.
Alright.
Okay, I go load world. I go edit settings. It may just be as simple as creative or survival. I mean, I selected creative. But there's also advanced. Okay, so creative means unlimited resources, instant building, no death. Survival means realistic manageable resources, inventory capacity, death, and respawn. And I guess I can make like everything larger, but yeah, so I'm guessing you just have to flip it to creative and everything should be good. Probably. It seems like creative is the way to get a handle on this. And I guess you can still have,
asteroids.
Meteor showers, because I had them and we were in creative. Oh, enable copy-paste. Okay, when you go to advanced, that's what they wanted. There's a checkbox for enable copy-paste. And that's what you want.
I see. Look, environment hostility, you want, there's safe, normal, cataclysm, and Armageddon. Yeah, we want Armageddon.
Yeah, probably. Or at least Cataclysm. I don't know. Yeah, we might as well go Armageddon. We don't have much time left in this free weekend, so we might as well see what they got.
7 large asteroids?
Sure. And don't forget the max players. Although I guess 4 is alright. Both of us were able to handle 4 just fine.
Permanent death should be off, right?
Yeah, I guess. Okay, let me know when you're ready and I will right-click you on a new.
I put it creative, public, 4 players, Armageddon, large asteroids. Let's try this. I get the feeling this isn't gonna be easy. Oh, server name is Speedball 3.
Speedball. Yeah, it probably appears on servers.
Check the box with friend.
Friend games, I don't know. That's strange, it isn't showing up.
It's still loading for me.
Not explain it.
Alright, meteor shower inbound. And I can build stuff.
There we go, found it. So it's weird, it's under games, not servers. I think the difference is servers are dedicated and games are just player hosted, like local hosted. Anyway, joining on you. It says your world size is now 4 megs. Woohoo. Wait, but then when it says downloading world, it says 3. That must be the discrepancy you talked about when you joined mine, huh?
Yep.
Anyway, while it downloads again, I should go watch that video tutorial.
Indeed, to stratify. Jump by pressing S.
Yeah, you can also
sprint by holding shift.
From what you're saying,
crouch
the
by
asteroids
pressing
sound
C.
Amazing.
Switch the jetpack on and
meanwhile,
off.
Meanwhile, I'm
pressing
watching
X.
A video tutorial in a window.
Jetpack movement is similar to
Steam
walking.
Overlay.
Fly up by pressing F or space. Fly down by pressing toolbar config.
I like Infinite Ammo, that's pretty cool.
To the toolbar at the bottom
this
of the screen.
This game like, you know, gritty reboot and asteroid.
To my toolbar.
Well,
armor
yeah,
small,
now that you turn the
small range,
settings to Armageddon,
interior light, and gravity generator. The toolbar config screen. Press a numeric key to select a building block or tool on your toolbar.
Feels pretty sick. Whoa, hey, what? Blocks.
And add a if you armor blocks can have different color the brush like a degrees in Z-axis, so that the object cannot be connected. Same time rate. Electricity is generated by nuclear reactors and conducted through any type of block.
I should stop this video.
This is an example of light being cut off the electricity source.
Wikipedia 2077. Come on, I should be in the hour. Whoa. I joined in. This is the first thing I see. Wow. So at least you got the Gatling turrets up, right? Oh, that's a lot of meteors. Definitely a lot of meteors.
I'm thinking,
meteor storm inbound.
Gonna try and...
I'm gonna go crit the shippers. Why aren't there any ships? That's weird. When it generated by it created a bunch of ships. Maybe that was just a thing I had different.
I'm just dismantling these so we can, when we build the ship, we can put Gatlings on it.
This at least feels like some of this.
You can put them on the platform.
No, I can't
come on the platform. Try tearing off the jetpack.
Okay. No, I still can't. I can't place anything.
Maybe there's lag.
Yeah, but I keep trying. I mean, clearly you can place stuff since you put all the turrets. Coming right now.
I wish to get out of the way. Okay.
I mean, not that we can die. But yeah, I don't know what it is, but I just. Maybe, like, this is your platform and not mine. I mean, it makes sense to have some sort of layer segregation like that. Question is then, where can I build stuff for my own? Whoa! Whoa! I got thrown way off the platform by a meteor. Okay. Your tower is gone, by the way.
What? Oh, shit. I'm trying to build a ship. Hey, what happened here? What do you need for a ship again?
Meteor storm inbound.
Wait, maybe if I just make a new small ship. Okay.
Why isn't the turret work? I don't understand. Oh shit. Do you need a power source for the turret to work?
Maybe I need to create a bunch of blocks first. It let me get as far as a new small ship, but it's not letting me attach stuff to stuff.
What do you need for a ship again? You said control panel, thrusters, platform, and what?
Let me check stuff. I guess you need the cockpit or control station.
All the stuff that you placed is just popped in.
Inbound. What the holy what?
Oh
Oh, now it's working. Huh.
Oh, this is lag.
That was some lag, I gotta tell you. At least I can belt stuff. Okay, so I got my ship with a bunch of light armor rocks. Assuming I don't get hit by stuff. Okay, there's one foot, and let me go to G and look at all this stuff. What do I have? Okay, I think it's like the stuff we have, actually. Small reactor, control station, thruster, and gyroscope. I don't think the landing gear is needed. So, like, the blocks it starts you out with are all you need to create a ship. Pretty sure. Yeah, the 1 through 5.
The 1 through 5 that we start with. Alright, I'll build one and I'll put some guns on it. Or maybe I'll just use the platform that we're on. Maybe not the best idea, actually. This thing is getting torn up.
Okay, so...
Removing these blocks so I can make a floating platform, and we'll go from there.
Storm inbound. Oh, I just realized.
Thruster-wise. I have it all wrong. I need thrusters in my front too. I can't just put all the guns in the front. Then I can't back up. There. The bracket keys on your keyboard change the color things. Huh. Neat. Didn't realize that. Okay. So. There we go.
Well, my ship isn't working.
Look at how many thrusters I got in my thing. Seems enough, right?
Yep. Let me see what I'm missing. Meteor
storm inbound.
Oh no, another meteor storm inbound. I really should put some of those turrets, shouldn't I?
Attached.
Control station not available for a small ship. I think I can only put cockpits. That could be it. Window blocks, cockpit blocks. Okay, I'm gonna need a cockpit. There we go, I have a cockpit. That's all I want.
Why isn't my thing moving?
Meteor storm inbound.
Oh, I see that, bro.
Okay, I put down my power and my reactor and my gyroscope, so my ship should be flyable now. Press K to open ship control panel. Gatling gun. I don't know how to actually fire stuff though, that's the thing.
I got the thrusters to work.
But I do have a ship. I have a working ship. See? Look at me. Can you see me?
Yeah, I see you. Good job. I don't know how you did that, but that's cool.
Did you catch your ship? Oh, yeah, it's cash. Okay, you got the gyroscope. Do you have power yet?
What's the power thing look like?
Check it out. It is, I think, 3? Yeah, block 3, your default loadout. Okay, I placed one for you. Oh, you already have a power. That's weird. Okay, and you've got a... Okay, maybe you need a cockpit, not just the control chair. That might be it. Maybe the control chair. Why would actually the control chair let people fly when we had it? I don't know. So basically, you can make small ships that can have the direct Gatling guns and rocket launchers, because I guess small ships are basically like Wing Commander fighters. And then you can build large ships that can have the turrets that auto-track and auto-fire at the asteroids and stuff. And, oh, I hope one of those asteroids doesn't hit my ship, because that would be real bad. You can take it for a spin if you want. Now, I can't figure out how to link the Gatling gun and rocket launcher to actually fire. So...
What you need is a
meteor storm inbound.
Okay, you must be attached to some, because I'm activating your thruster, but it's not moving. So, go check this out. I mean, I thought it was disconnected, but... I mean, it looks like it's disconnected. Oh, maybe... Okay, I think I figured it out. Either it's the landing gear, or you actually need to go, like, belt small ship when you do it, rather than just placing blocks. That could be it.
I'm having trouble controlling my, anything.
Okay, yeah, when you hit G, it says new small ship, new large ship, new station, right?
Yep.
And I think that's the key. If you just put down blocks, I think it acts as if you're building a station, as in it's going to be stationary no matter how many thrusters you put on it. Whereas, if you go G and then new small ship or new large ship, you'll create something that can move.
Oh wait, where do you get new small ship and large ship from?
When you hit G.
Meteor storm inbound.
Like, it's in the blocks?
Huh?
I see what you mean, yeah.
Okay, and I think that's what tells it to, like, make stuff that can actually move. It probably has to do with, like, netcode and everything, right? It needs to know what blocks are going to be something that can move around. There we go, new large ship coming in. Oh god, it got hit by a meteor already. Ship cockpit on mine. So that's why it's a bit simple. Okay, I've got a gyroscope. Two reactors. Now my big ship is online. Got a missile turret and a regular turret on my big ship now. Hey, it's working. You see it moving?
Yes.
It's like a giant Lego brick. This is pretty.
Meteor storm inbound.
I mean,
you know, this is the game Star Forge should be.
Star Forge. I'm sure they've made a few updates since last we're there. Nope, sorry, don't mean to bump you. I just made like a giant red transformer floaty thing with the gun on top. I'm thinking, you know, there's not really much to fight against other than just random asteroids plunging in. But it seems to me this with the Neko being. Oh god, no! No! Your ship! Oh god, look at my ship! It got hit by an asteroid too, the engines fell off. Oh man. Okay, well, the asteroids are more dastardly than we expected, but I'm thinking, like, you know, the netcode seems actually pretty solid, at least for the small player things we've encountered. I think Corgi mentioned that it, like... I think Corgi mentioned that, like, it gets worse the more stuff you build, the more things you have active going around. But that makes sense. Really. So...
Meteor storm inbound.
Okay, I wanted to make sure that was safe. Anyway... So it seems like the... Most of the functionality for this would come in multiplayer, where you could have people that, I guess, join specific teams and try to belt their ships and battle
it out. I've been trying to make my own thing, so... Like, you have to put thrusters, like, all over?
Yeah, any way you want to turn. Like, a meteor took out all my right thrusters, so now, like, I can't go that way. I if I press A, I don't go to the left, because there's no thruster that'll push me that way. So I'd have to, like, get out and rebuild my thrusters on that side. Work. So, like, you don't have any thrusters on a couple of your sides, and you just can't move that way. Anyway, Alright, G. Is it not G? Players. Anyway, in one of the menus I think only you have access to, because you created it, like, you can put people on different teams or factions or whatever. So I think that's probably how it'd play out.
Well, okay, it's insane. I just need the generous.
And the free weekend is just about over. So
yeah,
I guess
the sale lasts longer than the free weekend.
Yeah, the free weekend's ending like right now. But the sale will be going another
Hold on, I almost got this.
16 hours maybe. Nice. Ironically bedazzled. So anyway, I gotta go now, but thanks for playing the free weekend.
No problem, let's see if this thing works before you go.
What thing works?
Whoa, it works!
You've got thrusters now. You've got the touch. You've got the power.
Yep. Yeah, you know, this is oddly fun. I don't know why. I mimic it when I'm doing it.
I think they made Lego spaceships and, you know, it actually works. Like, we were able to just join, you know, each other's games with no mess, no hassle. Like, even right-click join from Steam works. And just get to building. Oh, looks like my ship is... I ran into the asteroid or something. And my ship's falling apart.
I'm just gonna drive right into the field because I can. Come on! Is that all you got?
I guess I could run into the asteroid if I could even steer, but... Oh, not kidding. Oh, there we go. Yeah, it looks like colliding with asteroids or other things at high enough velocity will destroy your ship. See? My ship is finally destroyed. Look at that. I'm just drifting off into space inside the cockpit.
Storm inbound.
You see it?
I'm trying to figure out where you are.
I might be on the other side of the asteroid, but my ship is just basically drifting around in parts right now. I'm where the platform used to be. Now it's all bashed up.
I gotta screenshot this.
Yep.
Alright, that's good. I'm happy. Yeah, you know... What's surprising is that it's pretty easy to learn how to build stuff, so that's cool. You just build yourself a basic ship and then you're flying around.
Yeah, it took us, you know, less than a couple hours. That's actually not bad. I was, given what Corgi was saying, I was afraid this is going to be way more complicated. Or at least, it's probably more complicated in survival, where you gotta mine the resources.
I'm happy that, like, the thrusters are, like, easy, you know, and that they recognize your movement, and I don't know how the thrusters, like, work, you know, coding-wise.
Yeah, it's just WASD and space and control. Easy. Anyway, thanks for playing. I'll see you next time.
See you.
Bye.